Today, another tutorial that's based around non-destructive workflow whilst working in Adobe Illustrator. However, today we're going to be focusing on logo design specifically when talking about non-destructive workflow in Adobe Illustrator. In today's video on logo design tips, I have some non-destructive workflow tips, but also logo design tips in general that I've never shown on this channel before. Firstly, however, I have an old gem, the transparency mask. You might have seen this before on my channel, and you might know how to use a transparency mask in Illustrator, but I'm going to show you how useful it is and when it comes in handy in logo designing. So let's say we want to cut out this shape into the circle for a kind of logo symbol. Firstly, we can make the actual shape itself the same color as the canvas with the eyedropper tool, and this is going to show us how the final logo mark will look. Normally, a designer will select both these shapes by holding down Shift, and then use the minus front option in the Pathfinder window. You end up with the final solution, but you cannot go back and easily change the shape itself. To get past this, select the circle, and then in the transparency window, apply a mask. You will need to uncheck the clip option and then highlight the right window. Go back to the shape and copy it with Command or Control C, and then paste it into the right hand side window with Command or Control V. Now you can move this shape around in any layout order you wish. Select back onto the symbol, click the left hand side box in the transparency window. And then as you can see, the shape has been cut into it. But now we can go back into the transparency window and make adjustments whenever we need. The next tip I have for you today when designing a logo in Illustrator is to always proof your logo in terms of size. A design might look awesome and amazing, but do you know how it appears in a smaller size? The logo may be used on a business card, for example, which is going to be quite a small size indeed. And so, I suggest that you mock up the final design like I've done here, and then print out this document, so you can see how the design functions at different scales. This is something I suggest you always do when designing a logo design. The next tip for when you're designing a logo is reflection. So you might have a design you like a lot, or maybe you feel like something's not quite right, or it's just not finished yet. Duplicate the design with the Alt Option key, and then reflect it like so. This will help show you issues with the kerning, but also you can get to see the shapes of what they actually are, instead of the shapes in their context. This can show weaknesses in your design, and also show areas that need to be worked on. This helps me a lot when I'm getting closer to the final design solution when working on a logo project. The next logo design tip relates to logo type. Never ever use a font as standard for your logo designs. The logo type is vastly important to the overall design, and so you always want to address things such as kerning and tracking. You want your logo type to be original, yet completely relevant to the logo and the brand itself. So press Command or Control T to open up the type window, and then have access to these measurements that will allow deeper customization. You can also outline the lettering and ungroup them, allowing you for further precise customization. And as we looked earlier in the tutorial, you can also reflect the logo type and address the kerning this way. Many designers find it easier to do by reflecting the logo type below. I also unfocus my eyes to see the negative space between each lettering quite easily. Lastly, in today's video, another point for non-destructive workflow. You need to be organized with your work, and this is my external hard drive you can see on screen. Notice I am in a folder that's named Graphic Design Work. Then I have each folder for a specific year, and then within each single year, I have each project. Then, as I go into each project folder, I have a final designs folder specifically made for the final design solutions. I could maybe make things even more organized by having monthly folders and so forth, but for me this is ideal. You do need to try and be as organized as you can to a certain degree, as it's going to benefit your workflow immensely. So that was today's video on non-destructive workflow techniques when logo designing. If you like what I do here and you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button to be reminded every single time I upload a video. Drop a like on this video if you did find it useful, and of course let me know in the comment section below what you want to see on this channel here at Satori Graphics. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.